Hello everyone, Trent Hummel with the Western Equipment Dealers Association Dealer Institute Training and Consulting Division. Today we're going to talk about websites. It's amazing after 25 years, we're still talking about the importance of websites to a dealership's success. Now, years ago, there was a study done. It incorporated seven different industries in North America, agriculture being one of them. It was discovered that agriculture was the top user of internet at that time. Now that's likely changed, but what hasn't changed is 85 to 90% of products are reviewed online before they're purchased. We all want to give the customer a good experience, but our limiting factor is that we have so few customers come through our doors in a day. You know, on a nice summer day, it might be 30 to 50 customers. On a winter day, it might be 5 customers or it might be less. So we don't have that many chances to interact or to have our people interact with those customers. Now the websites, they're open 24/7, and 3 in the morning when people should be sleeping, they're being reviewed. At 3 in the afternoon when they should be at work, they're being reviewed. So this is your dealership's opportunity to create a good customer experience, and a good website will do that. Now to start with this review of your website, you should draft up a template of what you want to review on it. And it only has to be an 8x11, there's got to be 10 or 12 questions on it. And it needs to be stuff about the assessment. How is my parts? Can I look up my parts online? Can I order parts online? How is my service? Does it promote service promotions? Used whole goods, new whole goods, short line, links to short lines. There's a number of things. Contact information. Most of us are using the websites now as a phone book. So is the phone number easily visible for all of your locations? Can we get to it easy? Now in that assessment, you should give that to your employees. Ask them to assess your website, ask your customers to assess, and ask non-customers. And you better be wearing big boy underwear when those assessments come back, because you're going to find out there's lots of room for improvement. And once you get past that, it's time to start building a website that'll work for you and create a customer experience. Now please don't hire the 15-year-old kid from high school because he's the cheapest guy in town and he can build a website. Look for a professional website design company and look for one that specializes in your industry. You know, maybe they've worked automotive or heavy truck or construction, but something similar to us. Probably 85 to 90% of our money comes in from people that are between 30 and 60 years old. So what kind of interaction, what kind of things do those people like on the websites? And we've got to maintain that at least 30% of our company's business should come from parts and service, so that needs some attention there too on your website. But after you get this built, designed, work with your professional development company and put together a program or a website design that will work. And I tip my hats to the OEMs that have done this already for their dealership body, and the dealership body can just borrow these websites or use these templates from this authorized provider. It takes a lot of time and effort away from the dealership having to spend that time looking for a provider and going through all the steps. Now after you get this design, it's time to use your analytics. Analytics are, it's hard data. It tells you what's working, what's not working on your website, what needs to be changed, what can be improved on, what they're clicking through, what they're spending time with. Websites aren't like a building where you build it once and that's it. Websites are forever going to change. Every month, every year, you're going to add stuff as the industry is able to add different types of interactive things on website design. You're going to have to incorporate them and you're going to drop off some old stuff. And now after all that, you're going to create a customer experience that hopefully is going to drive some customers to your business, so you get an opportunity to sell to them and resell to them and create a customer for life. And with all that, let's go to work. Thank you and stay safe.